Greetings, dear ones. Well, I'm here back in my room. I'm right now in Kanjangad, and it has been a fruitful day. And also, I had a personal session today, and it went on for close to 3 hours. One beautiful thing is that these coincidences are so mystical. Because last time I had a consultation, it was in Tirunamalai, and that person actually from UK wanted to know about something about Tirunamalai, and no idea that I was in Tirunamalai. And that session came up there only. Very fruitful experience. And this time, last week I had a session which I said I'm going to travel, so we fixed it on Monday, that is today, and go to see. That person also is connected with Nityananda and never been here, but has a certain pull here, and we ended up having the session today from this place, and very fruitful again, a wonderful almost 3 hour session. Anyways, I was talking about these sessions because in all the past sessions that I've been doing with people, one consistent thing I'm seeing, a certain pattern. And this pattern is something which is overwhelming people right now on earth. And this is happening very consistently. That is why I'm saying this is happening in the collective. From individual consciousness, multiple, when you see a certain pattern that is very common in the collective, you know this is happening in the collective consciousness. And that is this extreme overwhelmed feeling of purposelessness, meaninglessness. A certain confusion arising inside this mind, which is provoking the person to find more details deeper, but the person is confused as to how. Why means, you know, this overwhelming feeling, I'll tell you why it's happening. It's because of the surges in energy in the consciousness of the planet. It's rising beyond comparative levels, beyond, you know, our imagination. It's going at that rapid pace. The consistent energy rise on planet Earth is suddenly giving rise to all these symptoms that you can see in your body and mind. Many people are having many bodily symptoms. Many are having many mental symptoms, and they are feeling they are going crazy. They're not understanding what's happening, but all this turmoil is going on. Emotions are at its peak. All kind of emotions. If you see, people are getting miserable. They're feeling lonely. They're feeling isolated. They're feeling the need to be loved. You know, they're feeling deprived of something, and they're not understanding how to handle this life, how to handle the things. And suddenly feeling insecure about their future and how things will happen to them and their family members, and you know what's going to happen. And suddenly there is a rush for security, you know, some measures being taken for some desperate need to find some solution to it. And everybody is like, this is happening in the collective. People talk about it or not, no problem, but we can understand it through a certain pattern, and I can observe it in my own life also, the same patterns, but the intensity is not so high. But I can understand, if you are not practicing awareness, if the person is not, how they can get affected by it. It's very overwhelming, because I've been through all this. It's a weird and a horrid kind of feeling. So it's like everything has ended, and it's like completely no purpose in life, and what the heck am I doing here, and trying to find the meaning in life, and a certain emptiness, a certain void that is there within, which the human is unable to know how to fill it up. So when this urge comes in to fill up that void, because our senses are always bahimukhi, that is by drishti, always outside, we seek outside everything. We have been doing that for lifetimes, you know, from the time we have taken birth, we are always looking outside for satisfaction, for contentment, for love, for appreciation, everything from outside. So consistently we have practiced this, ki if I need something, I need to go get out. If I want love from somebody, I need to go out and seek it. If I want anything in life, even if I want energy in life, we have the habit of going outside and seeking, where can I get that energy from? If I want healing, the habit is to go outside and seek, who can give me healing? You know, whereas we have not realized all these things are within us. So until this happens, it can be very difficult. You know, so the current time is that. And I was saying, since we have been trained, we have
trained ourselves and the belief patterns are something that everything is outside, and we are looking outside, and suddenly there is a big void that's happening, the gap that's happening, which is prompting a person to find a replacement or to fill in that void. And since the senses are always running outside, now the person seeks more outside. Something missing, I need to desperately go for it, and the hunt is again outside. And when you don't get it outside, you get more miserable. This is again the pattern, and this is very unconscious. It is trying to seek things outside to fulfill it, without even pausing for a moment and seeing all these things about. People who are in awareness, who are practicing this awareness, will be able to reflect it without getting just reactive, without a purpose. Just reaction will not help, because you are not standing and observing there. So people are being pushed to the heights of wanting to leave their bodies. Many people have spoken to me about this. There are times when, because why the need to leave the body? Because purposeless. Purposelessness means there is no purpose in life now. What do we do sticking around? It's the same old story, repeating itself again and again all the time. And I'm stuck in this loop, finding no route out. So the only thing that comes to the conscious mind is how to find a route out is to leave the body. So people talk about it, often feel suicidal and all those things. And it's suddenly happening in waves right now. I can see a certain wave pattern when suddenly people are going into that upheaval, and it's so overwhelming for them to handle themselves, their lives, their emotions, their feelings, their thoughts, because it's just flooding out. And many feel that I'll go mad. I'll literally go haywire. What's happening to me? So many, I can't control it, you know. So please understand, if you are undergoing this, I don't mean that you have to undergo this, but if you realize somebody around you or some, you know, this is happening in this world, you will notice this pattern very frequently now. And that only gives us an indication of how emergent the need is to raise the consciousness, because the earth is not stopping. Cosmos is not stopping. There is some divine plan that is unfolding. We do not know exactly what, but it's happening at a very, very rapid rate. Like, it seems like the planet is no more patient. It just wants to go ahead in that rise in evolution. You call that planet, you call that universe, you call that cosmos, you call that God, whatever. I'm just saying from another interpretation that there is no patience. Actually, it doesn't happen that way, but I'm telling, it looks like that. There is no mercy shown to those who are not trying to adapt into these new energies. So it just means that enough of time given, now is the time to just kickstart and move ahead, to turn within. I'm seeing even myself doing a lot of work. My work was something else, but I can see in these past few weeks, whole attention that is happening from the awareness, from I don't know how and where, but these downloads that I get, you know, I get a lot of downloads which I pour it out in those videos. Like, for example, if I'm walking on the road and suddenly there will be some rush, you know, some alignment that's happening, and suddenly a downpour of thoughts, and it's so continuous, like I can't stop it. Even if I want to freeze my mind at the time, it doesn't stop. It's just over. So it is like something that is flooding this cosmos, the cosmic powers. I don't know how it's working. It's working differently on different people. For me, this is how it's happening. And so I feel the same urge that people feel to quickly act on it or react on it. So how I act or react on it is immediately I take up the phone and record it. So I don't want to lose what's coming through, you know. So right now also I had that gist, and that is what I'm doing it immediately, because these are precious. These give us hints to what's happening in the collective. If you see these videos, will relate to you somewhere or the other. That's what I'm telling. There's a commonality that's happening in the whole universe. And now, how to get adapted to this kind of energy surges is the only way is to raise your consciousness. And please understand, if the attention is always outside, it will be very difficult to align to that alignment, because the alignment happens from within. So knowing the purpose of life helps here, because the feeling of purposelessness is happening because we actually have not freezed our purpose of life. Not just thinking of the purpose of life, higher purpose of life, I'm telling you. Not to become a businessman or so and so. That you have, that's fine. But beyond that also, there is something that I'm telling you. That purpose, the higher purpose of moving towards liberation, or many people get jittered when I say liberation. They say it's an end of it. You know? And people don't like that idea of liberation, because liberation means you're done with. And especially if there are a lot of desires within, the first idea will cancel it. Who wants to liberate now? It's not you that is speaking. It is the unfulfilled desires that is speaking. You know, there's so much to see, so much to do. This is a general feeling that happens. So when these thought comes, if you are aware of this, you will catch the pattern. That's where I'm talking these things from. It will come, and if you identify it differently, you will come to know. Okay, this is not a true thought actually. It is coming in some false projection of the mind. So the only way is to feel purposeful is to know and remind yourself of the ultimatum. Ultimatum, you need not think about moksha and all that, because many people don't subscribe to that idea of moksha because they are still not ready for it, or still there is a lot of things inside, and you know, pending issues, unresolved issues and all that, blah blah blah, it goes on. So personally speaking, even when I speak of liberation or moksha, I'm not talking that, you know, we'll go and poof, vanish, because that's what happens naturally. Moksha means your complete nullification of all the gunas and all those things. And in the morning video you saw, it is frightening to many. It is frightening to think that I am not going to exist anymore. It's a very, very common feeling that can happen. Though you might not agree, subconsciously your body will react. Your mind, yourself will react. Oh, I don't want to finish it all. There's so much to do, and you know. So that idea to liberation is unsubscribed. You subscribe off of it. So I won't talk on that level, liberation. When I say liberation, I am just talking of the higher goal. I'm not saying achieve it in this lifetime. It's very easy to say achieve lifetime in this lifetime, liberation, but we don't know what is involved in, you know, dissolving, what amount of dissolving has to happen. Like you should have nothing. You should be a null person. Everything will go out. There's nothing till a complete zero, desireless state comes, and where you don't even are aware of your own existence. You know, that's what we call as mukti. So that's not a very relatable term to many. It's very scary. So I won't talk on that. Though that will happen eventually, but I'm not saying. Like for example, if you ask me about moksha in this lifetime, I'm not very keen on it. For me, today is very important. Right now, the moment is that I celebrate this moment. I should be in a position, my mind should be in a position, my feelings, my emotions, my body, my state of consciousness should be in a position right now to celebrate that consciousness, that feeling of having realized who you are. It's very liberating just knowing who you are and your eternity, that you don't die. You are, you're, you know, 60-70% of your concerns just drop like that, like a hot potato. It just drops. And that gives you a satisfaction that, oh, I'm not in a hurry, because where am I going? I never die. But my focus will be now to raise my consciousness to such a level that when I physically die also, I should be alert, I should be active and conscious about where my future journey is going to be like. If I am in a state practicing a lot of awareness, and I am my chetana, my consciousness is in that state of awareness, then it's obvious when you leave the body also, that awareness, that kind of awareness is there, and you know where you are heading very clearly, so that you have better choices to do in case you don't finish it in this lifetime also. So technically speaking, there is no hurry. Because when we say in this lifetime, it is like people say, oh, I'm already 50 years old or 60 years old. In 10 years, am I going to do that? So the 10 years goes in so much of stress and what you call it, target setting and target meeting, that they are unable to relish the current. For me, mukti, or what you call liberation, is right now. how free I am. Right now, how easygoing I am. Right now, how light I am. Right now, how much of freedom I have. Right now, being in that state of cheerfulness, these things are very important, because that this will directly relate to how your state is. Realizing that self, that is the main motive. You know, completely realizing that self, you must be having glimpses. We have glimpses, that's a different thing. But completely to stay in that realized mode of the self, those are the kind of some targets which I always place in front of me, because it's very achievable and I can see myself walking very closer to it. So if we put very practical things step by step, we won't be overwhelmed with life. There is no hurry. Otherwise, there is a lot of hurry and there is competition here again. I want to compete. You know, my loved one is going, no, I need to go before that. If there are spouses, two people living, no, I don't want you to die. Let me die first. You know, and they call it love. It's not love. It's the fear of living alone. Simple things. So all these things pop up during these sessions, and you know, all these bubbles break and we come to know, oh no, this is a false feeling that we are living in. So when you become aware of who you are, like somebody asked me today only in the session, a person asked me, when I look at you, I see a kind of freedom on your face and yourself and the way you are living life, and how are you able to do that? You must be having some bonus points in your life. I see somebody else, as you said, somebody else in the same building I see is in a certain state of mind and so cheerful and so happy and so free. And I look, and where am I stuck? I've been doing practices for 10 years, 12 years, nothing has happened like that. I mean, I have my good experience, but I don't see myself living in that kind of a freedom, that kind of celebration. So when I look at you, I always compare and say, I say, don't do that. It's not so difficult. It is all because we all are target oriented. We are all having some certain targets, and with the targets comes expectation. So whenever we do any kind of spiritual practice, it is with conditions applied, because the expectation is there. Because whenever we sit, or even when we are focused towards a spiritual journey, we have already set some big targets. Like, you know, if it is a worldly person and that person is growing and has interest in spirituality, if you talk to them about liberation, they'll puke out of fear. What the hell is this now? So, and I realize, because these talks that I'm doing here and all are towards ultimate liberation. Yes, it is not bad to have an understanding of it, wisdom of it, knowledge of it, because somewhere when you sink in these details, tomorrow or whenever that need be, it will rise up from your subconscious and it will be useful to you. So it doesn't mean that you need to achieve that in next 5 years or next 10 years, and these things don't work that way. Self-realization, liberation doesn't work according to our targets that we, like, you know, we fix in the worldly world. It doesn't work that way. There are so many factors. All that we can do is have an intense intensity towards those purposes, and the ultimatum we keep it as, okay, liberation, I'm moving towards that, but before that there are these milestones. Realizing first, who am I completely? Understanding my being, understanding my immortality, that I won't die like this. I exist even after this body will fall down. And that is where we slowly start getting a grip on it. Why I'm saying this is because this should be your purpose. If you know your purpose, and this is the ultimate purpose, I'm telling you, till you realize this, mark my words, till you realize your ultimate purpose of taking human birth, life will not allow you to settle down. It will again and again pinch you at that same place where it hurts the most. Why is it doing that? Is it angry with you? Or is it bugged off with you? Or is it jealous of you? Or, you know, it has a mean motive with you? Nothing. It is just concerned of you. So that you don't lose track, it keeps reminding you, it keeps pinching you whenever you are forgetting that purpose. And how do you forget the purpose? Any deviation that you take in this worldly life, whenever the moment you deviate, your antaratma, your inner being knows. It gives you a nudge. If you don't look at that nudge or realize or feel that nudge, it will give you a hard push. If you don't still get it, it will give you a big jerk. If you still don't, it will give you kick in the back, a kick in the back. So these jolts are all that we are experiencing. So the kick that I say is this wave of consciousness that is rising. With every wave, suddenly there are overwhelming emotions, overwhelming feelings, overwhelming fear, overwhelming thoughts running all the time. And if your body is not ready for it, you'll see your body falling sick. All different weird kind of symptoms. And with that fear and again manifesting, it is a loop. So instead of wasting time, I would always advise to stay tuned to your inner self. Make these opportunities. You live in the world, that's fine, but whenever you have opportunities, listen to things like this that will remind you of your goal, that will not forget, make you forget your ultimate goal, and make you simultaneously conscious and aware of this. And with these practices that you do, you develop and keep increasing that level of awareness. So when that person asks, how are you able to do it? I just said one thing. It is the practice of awareness. The practice of awareness helps me live in the moment, not worrying too much about future or not worrying too much about what is not in my hands. I worry only about what, not even worry, I just live in this moment. Because when I live, even I see that worry or that question that comes up, and it gets solved there only, because the whole attention and awareness is there. It shows you. So that worry also is very temporary. It comes there, then and there, it keeps on happening. So this is one way I said that I am able to live free. Whatever freedom you can see, or whatever you can, you cannot fake freedom. You cannot show off something on the screen or something, because it's very palpable. You can see, read it through the conscious, through the vibrations. There is something called intuition and feeling for everybody. So this is one I said. And secondly is, I don't get entangled into what is none of my business in the world. This is a secret mantra that I'm giving you. Do not get entangled with worldly affairs. World will run the way it is. There is nothing you can do about it. Don't try to reform it. Don't try to change it. Don't try to bring transformation to it. Don't try to save it. It is none of our business. Ramana once said, leave that to the creator who has created. He is more wise than you. Are you more wise than him that you are trying to save his world that he has created? Swami Vivekananda went once to a temple somewhere in Kashmir, and he was devastated to see that the divine mother's idol there, and the whole temple was damaged. And he learned that the Mughals had done it. The invaders had done it. They had destroyed the temples. And suddenly he's in a full of rage and standing there with bloodshot eyes, and he's praying to the divine mother, oh mother, only if I was there during that time, I would have taught them a lesson. How dare they touch your temples that you have made? You know, and then the mother's voice is heard, like something like, oh, so you are going to protect me. Means I am your protector. You are the one who is going to protect me. That the ego says, I am going to take control and I am going to protect you. How dare somebody invade? Because he said those words. He said, if I was there during that time, I would have protected, fought and protected my mother, divine mother. So she reminded him to get out of that illusion which the ego is creating, that you are the doer. It's all the play of consciousness. She also said, the divine mother's voice said, if I want, I can create 1,000 temples. Do you think I need you for that? Because I'm the one who created this entire cosmos. You think it is a problem for me to create one temple? See, the moment that happened, Swami Vivekananda dropped there. And he wrote, he has written this word. He said, I lost all my patriotism that day. The patriotism, everything is good, but ultimatum is beyond all that. Because there also we feel we are doing something. And this is a Srishti, this is the earth school, which will be like this. You cannot change it. You change it, it will reset itself. Because this nature of earth is to ever change. All the time it is changing. You cannot make it stop at a certain way. You cannot say, that is why the yugas happen. 4 yugas, it keeps changing. You can't settle down and say, oh, finally, we are in Satyuga. After some time, that will move into Dwapar Yuga, Treta Yuga, and also Kali Yuga. So in Kali Yuga, you cannot say, oh my God, it's all darkness. We are gone forever. No. After a certain time, again, reset to Satyuga. So every Yugas, we come and play this role. I am the savior. I am reforming. I got to do this. I got to save the masses. Ramana just said, you save yourself. That's more than enough. Everybody concentrate on saving themselves. The whole world will be saved. And till you are awake and conscious, only till then the world is alive to you. You close that, you don't exist, the whole world vanishes. It's not there. That is mithya. That is maya, what is called. See how beautifully he said. One example I'll give you to realize that is, when you're sleeping, when you go to sleep, the whole world diminishes. And you know, it merges into you and it's vanished. In sleep, where do you know? Where is the world? Who you are, you don't know. Your identity, your name, your problems, your sickness, everything is nullified. Your mother, father, brother, sister, husband, son, grandfather, where do they exist? They're all gone. You might be the best of mother, you might be the best of father. All gone in the sleep. Only your pure consciousness, every identity gone. So, when the night comes, is when what we call as, you know, the world has vanished. Maya is gone. So see, Maya exists only when the mind is awake. Next morning, the moment you awake, everything comes back. All the roles you played, all the problems you had, everything just comes back. Means, Maya has come back. When is the Maya active? When the mind is open and active and awake. The moment mind ceases, the whole world vanishes. It doesn't exist. See, there's a null. It's a void. This is how you can relate to Maya very clearly. So when all these things are so temporary, only when you're looking at it, you can be a part of this world. When you're not looking at it, it doesn't exist for you. In this illusory world, it was said, are you going to save somebody? These things will keep on happening. Are you getting it? So why I added this note also, it will give you relief to know that these things are not permanent. These things keep changing. So there is no need to save anyone, help, you know, in beyond your certain level, go there and, you know, sacrifice your life for it and go for that. Everything is a drama, you know. Even if you sacrifice, you are going to come back and play another role until, because karma is only bothering about the lessons you learn. It doesn't go for your valor or, you know, the courage and how much you can destroy yourself for it or commit to something. It doesn't work that way. So, knowing this, the purpose, why I keep on telling again these kind of stories is you'll know the temporariness of this. This is very important. When you know the temporariness of your life only, you will think of that higher purpose. Okay, this is all temporary. Where is my permanent home? I got to return back to home. That is when I start thinking, okay, that's there, my ultimate. Okay, so then my perspective changes and the way I live today also changes. Then you will know it is such a short life in this body also. You don't know when you are going to exist. You never know. So why not relish this current moment and live? So do not get entangled. This is what I said. First is live a life of awareness. In that you'll see you're living in the present moment where you give very less importance to your mind and ego. You are more in your soul consciousness. So you, that will give you the bliss and happiness. And the second is do not entangle into worldly affairs, unwanted worldly affairs. Put your hand and feet and toes and fingers into all problems of here and there, unwanted things. Withdraw and remain within yourself as much as possible. Of course, I am not saying do not help. We can help. But please understand there are limitations beyond which if you go, you will get sucked into that new void which will never fill. So hope this video helps. in the evolution of your soul and in understanding this whole thing, and it has put light, I hope, into your being. With this, I take your leave. Tomorrow I might do a live. I'll keep you updated. With much divine love and light to you. Stay blessed.